Hi guys, it is the Wednesday and I'm getting ready to take my braids out because it's time. Like, the thing about when you do light colored braids and your hair is dark, you can really see the new growth. Hopefully it's picking up on camera, but I'm gonna go ahead and take my braids out and I'm gonna try something different. I think maybe if I turn to the light you can see it better. So I think I'm going to, I have a lace wig, but I don't want to be gluing, I don't feel like gluing lace on my head every day. So I'm either going to try and do the behind the hairline method with the lace, or I'm going to cut the lace and make it a U-part wig. I don't know. We're going to see. But I'm going to go ahead and start taking these out. And then we're going to wash my hair. I'm probably going to do a steam mask. Like, look, you can see my hair coming out of the braids. So they have to come out. Do like a steam mask and all of that. So that's what we're gonna do today. I have today's video. Well, I can't believe my scissors just broke. Found some scissors. Okay, so all the braids are out. My hair has grown so much since I cut it. Yeah, we're gonna go wash my hair now. I can't wait until it grows out more so I can have like a big fro. One of these days, maybe I'll try a twist out. I've never really been a twist out girly, but we'll see. I've been thinking about getting a relaxer though, I'm not even gonna lie. But the thing about my hair is so fine. I know it looks like I have a lot of hair, but my hair is really fine. So anytime I get a relaxer, or even when I straighten my hair, like it's so thin. I know if I get a relaxer, my hair is going to be so flat and thin and it's not going to have like any body, any movement to it. So I'm thinking maybe I'll try a keratin treatment. But I want to get to a phase where I can just like wear clip-in extensions or something. Because I love being able to just like hit my scalp. That's why I've been wearing braids so often, because I can still like get to my scalp. I'm like over wigs, like a full lace wig. That's why I'm gonna see what I can do with this wig that I have. Cause I don't wanna get rid of it, but I know I'm not going to be gluing a wig on. But let's go ahead and wash this hair. So I just finished washing my hair. And when I was washing my hair, I had so much buildup on my hair. It actually was disgusting. The main oil that I use is the Milani. And this oil is amazing, but my two bottles that I have here are practically empty, so I've been having to mix it with other stuff. So last week I mixed it with this oil that I got for PR, and it's a really good oil. Like, I like this oil, but I think mixing the two together is not good. I also had tea tree oil on my hair. So just that's the oil that I've been using for my braids. And I think mixing all of the oils together is just not a good idea. So I just need to stick to like one. I think I'm just going to stick to this on my scalp, the Milani on my scalp, and then this like on the ends of my hair. But I thought I had some pre-poo. Did not have any pre-poo. So that was annoying, but I did have two samples of Milani from my last order from them. I had some samples, and one was a detoxifying mask, and then one was the shampoo version of the oil that I use. So I put the detoxifying mask on my scalp and I let that sit for probably like 5 minutes. Maybe I should have let it sit longer. And then I went in with the rosemary mint. I went in with the rosemary mint shampoo, and that like really cleaned up my scalp. So I'm going to go ahead and order the actual shampoo of those and get my pre-poo. My pre-poo is by Milani too. They make really good products. So I'm just going to go ahead and order the rose water shampoo and the conditioner. Might as well get both. Some more pre-poo and that detoxifying mask. So the detoxifying mask was good. I need to start taking better care of my hair. And the way like that build up was disgusting. Steam my hair, so that's why I'm filling up my little water. And I have my steamer here. I also have an Olipop cherry vanilla. So good. Sew-ins, whew, crazy. And only heat damage I have is the front of my hair, which is what gets flat ironed the most. So I'm not, you know, too mad at it. But this is why I said I think I want to get like a keratin treatment or something, because I just, oh, is this a little bit of heat damage too? It's a little bit of heat damage over here. But that's not bad. And I'm going to just put, I'm out of my hair mask too. I'm just out of everything. So I'm just going in with my regular conditioner. Go ahead and finish steaming my hair. I'm putting this conditioner in because I need to get as much moisture into my hair as possible. And I'm going to let this whole steamer go. Like until all the water is out. So I will check in with you guys after I'm done. And we'll figure out, what are we going to do? We're going to do the hairline method for the wig, or we're going to cut it and make it a U-part. Wow, none of that was recording, and I've already sectioned off my hair. That's annoying. I was saying I need to get my hair cut and get all those split ends cut off and get it evened up and get like some clip-ins so I can start wearing my hair. And I went ahead and I sectioned it. Because I am going to make the wig into a U-part wig. Okay, so I just placed the wig on. And I was thinking maybe I will do just the flip-over method with it. Because, I mean, just it sitting here looks cool. I feel like I can try the flip-over method. If I don't like it, then I can take it off and then do the V-part. So I will need to go and just braid this up. I think I'm just gonna take this little piece out, put that braid back, seal that down. But I just did like a semi beehive for the braid pattern. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna do the flip over method. So I will talk to you guys after I put this wig on. You want to wrap me all up and take me home with you. See what I look like under the mask. I'll keep it quiet. Okay, so this is what we have. I'm actually gonna style it in the morning, but I think it works. I could have pulled out because my edges are a little thin on this side, so I wish I would have pulled out a little bit more hair. But I think I'm gonna be good the way that I style it. So I think I'm gonna do flip this way and then do a bunch of curls. But yeah, I think it looks good. This is why I did not want to do a wig, because I'm gonna be going back to the gym next week, like actually lifting weights. I don't have a place to sit you guys in the bathroom. So I have this weird angle. But I'm gonna be sweating and I wanna be able to like pull my hair up. Like this, I think I might even do this for the Christmas party. Like a half up, half down. Ooh, that'd be cute. But I want to be able to throw my hair into a high ponytail for the gym and put a sweatband on for my edges. And I'm going to be able to do that with the wig sewn on instead of it actually being glued on. I love it. I think, wow, this is probably what I'm going to do from now on. Get me a curly wig and just sew it on. Because it's minimum leave out. Like, the only leave out I have is my perimeter. So I'm going to have to just be really careful with treating my perimeter so that it stays healthy. But the girlies on TikTok, who said to put your wig behind your hairline, babe, y'all was onto something. Y'all was really onto something. But that is it. I'm going to go. Oh, I'm actually filming an outro for this video. But thank you for watching. If you made it this far, make sure you go ahead, like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for day 8 of Vlogmas. Okay, bye.